Hi, I'm David with General Air. Today we're going to talk about five ways to know that your weld is good. The first way to tell if your weld is good is by the size. The weld on the right is a consistent size from point A to point B. The weld on the left has some parts where it necks down. This is caused by irregular travel speeds. If you move your gun too fast, the size of your weld is going to suffer. Now, if I was measuring this weld, I would measure it from here to here, which would only measure about an eighth of an inch. Drastically less strength in this weld comparatively to this weld. The second way to tell if your weld is good is by checking for porosity. The weld on the right has no visible holes on the face. The weld on the left has holes throughout the entire length of the weld. This is due to an inadequate gas coverage. The nitrogen that's in the air diffuses with the molten weld metal and causes your weld to look like Swiss cheese. This weld is dramatically less strong than this weld. The third way to see if your weld is good or not is to look for undercut. Undercut is where the arc dug out the base metal, but it didn't get filled back in, either by going too fast or not pausing long enough, like in this case where we're going vertical up. We didn't pause long enough on the sides and we waited too long in the middle. An easy way to check for undercut is to take a flashlight and shine it down the length of the weld. Wherever you see shadows, that's where you know that the filler metal didn't fill back in the base metal. This causes a sharp notch. That sharp notch can become a stress riser if a lot of load is placed on these two plates and could crack the weld all the way down. The fourth way to see that if your weld is good or not is to look at the bead profile. This bead in particular is slightly convex, so it's humped up. I know for a fact that this bead was done about a volt too low. If I were to turn my machine up one volt higher, the bead would have flattened out and gotten a little bit wider. Because remember, voltage is bead profile, and wire feed speed is amperage, which is your penetration. The fifth and final way to know if your weld is good is doing what's called a cut and etch. Now, this is where you would set your machine up for the parameters that you're planning on running and getting a scrap piece of the base metal thickness that you're using and doing a couple of beads. Then you take it over to your saw, cut it, polish it up with some Scotch-Brite and pour some acid on top of it. In this case, we're using a phosphoric acid we just got from our local hardware store. And what will happen is that the base metal grains and the grains of the weld nugget are different sizes, and the weld nugget will show up in this bright little spot you can see here. Then you can judge how much penetration you actually got into the base metal. Now, this being a fillet weld, all we really need to do is get at the root of the weld where those two pieces meet. And we did that actually pretty well. Got quite a lot of penetration on that one. That is the most powerful way to know if your weld is going to be good or not.